Okay, so today I want to explain the sumcheck protocol. So the sumcheck protocol, you might have heard of it, is kind of like a staple in the ZK world. And it basically allows you to create a proof. It's an interactive proof between a prover and a verifier, where the prover wants to prove that the value h is the sum of some polynomial that takes multiple variables. So if we have, actually, if we have the polynomial f that takes x1, x2, and x3, like a multivariate polynomial, we want to prove that h is the sum of all of the evaluations of that polynomial when the points or the variables takes the value 0 or 1. So I can write it like this. Of course, there's a fancier way to write it, but this is really to drive the points. It goes on and on until f 1, 1, 1. So you want to prove that by evaluating all of these evaluation of the polynomial at these different points, and by the way, we call that the Boolean hypercube. Hypercube. And this is really just a fancy word to say I want all of these values in 0 and 1. So it's not really important, but maybe you've seen that. So, okay. So you want to do that protocol, and we don't want the verifier to like evaluate all of these values. You know, it's a lot of values to evaluate and add. We want to do this interactive protocol between a prover and a verifier so that we can do that efficiently. And the first thing that the prover does is that they send a polynomial g to the verifier, and the verifier checks that g0 plus g1 is equal to h. They will check that. And this tells the verifier that if g is correctly formed, that then h is indeed the sum of this polynomial. And what do I mean by g is correctly formed? It means that if g of x1, so g is univariate, only one variable. If g of x1 is equal to f of x1, 0, 0, plus f of x1, 0, 1, plus f of x1, 1, 0, plus f of x1, 1, 1. If g of x1 is equal to that sum, and it's correctly formed, right? This is that polynomial, then we've proven that h is the sum. So that's enough. That should be enough. Except that at this point in time, the verifier doesn't know if g is correctly formed. G could be any polynomial. And indeed here, actually, we just need to specify that, but the prover sent the polynomial to the verifier. There are optimizations where the prover doesn't have to send the polynomial to the verifier. Lately in that paper called Hyperplunk, they talk about such an optimization, but I'm not gonna talk about it. So if you know the Schwartz Zippel lemma, which, you know, I'm not gonna explain what the Schwartz Zippel lemma here, but briefly remind you that it's a good way to check if two polynomials are equal. And the way to check if two polynomials are equal is that you sample a random point. So the verifier can send random points after that polynomial was locked. And then they can check if g of r is equals to whatever is the other polynomial at that point. So we want to check if it's equal to basically this. Gonna write everything so that it's clean. It's not R1, by the way, it's just R. I don't know why I wrote R1. But yeah. If we can show that G of R, which the verifier can compute because they sampled R and they have G, is equal to that sum, then we're good. We know that G, that polynomial, was correctly formed because we know it's correctly formed at one point that we sampled randomly, and so the probability that it's these two polynomials are not equal is very, very low. That's the Schwartz-Zippel lemma. But notice here that basically this thing here is a value we can call h2, and this thing here is basically the same param we had earlier, except that we're only changing two variables. We have no new polynomial that only has two variables going through the Boolean hypercube. And one of the variable has been instantiated to that random value r, so it doesn't exist anymore. And so we basically recurse into our problem. We have a new problem when we're trying to prove that H2 is the sum of a new polynomial that we can call, I don't know, F2 maybe, over the Boolean hypercube. And so basically, we do exactly the same up until we don't have any variables anymore. And that's how we do a number of back and forth that's equal to the number of variables in the polynomial. So that's the intuition behind the sum check. I was trying to be very brief, so I think this video is going to be under 6 minutes, and I'm going to leave it at that. You can dig more into it, you can see the details, you can check how the protocol actually works from start to finish, or you can check the optimizations in Hyperplunk, but I just wanted to give you some intuition in this video.